right of where you entered in.
The one without the slide.
The one without the slide, that is correct. You look down the corridor, and it seems to be made of the same type of thing that the rest of the corridors are, you know, just like sheared away, right? So these corridors are sort of like blank. It's 20 foot wide. It's easily 10 foot high plus, so these are actually quite spacious you know, corridors that you're walking through right now. There is an I forgot to mention, there are archways on all of these different corridors. Okay, so there are no doors on the inside of the circular room, just like, you know, circular archways that go up to these various places.
Are there stone hinges? Like, it looks like there, does it look like there might have once been doors?
No, it doesn't look like there are ever doors on there. Okay, and in fact, the, And in fact, you happen to know, just in general, that things that you make doors for and things you don't make doors for are fundamentally different. So this thing is not made for a door. It would never attend that before. Okay. So the witch moves it. You look up the passageway, and there doesn't seem to be much in it. It seems to be perfectly smooth in all the various other stuff.
Is it going slightly down?
No, it's going slightly upward.
So really, this one all goes by the other.
They're all going slightly upward. They're all banked at around 10 degrees up from this room.
But this one does, the only difference is this one doesn't have a blue slide thing.
That is correct. This one does not have a blue slide. You got it. Okay.
So what about the next one?
Oh, you want to look down the mall?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sure. Okay. So the next one, which direction? You keep going right?
Sure.
Okay. So you look at the next one to the right, or counterclockwise. Okay. That one looks like it has a human statue in it. Yes, another statue.
In the hall.
In the hall. Okay. And this one has a pick in its hand. And it looks like it's, you know, right in the middle of working. Like
right. Nina, can you light it up? You know,
yes. Now, by the way, you wouldn't be able to see it without it being lit up. So right. Assuming you light it.
So actually, let's examine it closely. Let's see it's another one of those former denizens of this place.
Okay, you would have to go down into the hall if you want to.
Let's take a few steps in.
No, you would have to go down. You want to look at it? You have to go down into the hall.
Into the hall.
Can we go into the hall?
You detect evil. You do not detect an evil.
Let's go.
Let's glance at all of the hallways first.
Let's glance at all of them, and then make decisions as to what we're doing.
Okay, perfect. Okay, sure. So you take a look down the next hall. In this one, all of these corridors, by the way, the corridor that you came in looked like it was at most 60 feet long. These corridors look like they're definitely longer than 60 feet. So you're casting out as far as you can, your light as far as you can, and there's more corridor to it, so they got out farther than that. Okay. This corridor also looks like it's longer than 60 feet. And it looks like just all the other corridors with the raceways in it. It's got the blue, you know, thing down the center. It's sloping a little bit.
Okay, but the only one with anything else in it is the one with the statue.
But we'll leave
the
last
statue so far. The last one?
Wait, what's the middle one? The next one? They have nothing. It's just
this one has nothing.
Okay.
Right. You bastard.
What's the matter?
I didn't put two encounter areas on here.
Uh-oh.
There's nothing in there for you to encounter. It looks like this ever in the passageway. Right, exactly, yes.
Speechless, like it's another dimension.
Like the do-do-do-do-do-do.
You can't go into it.
What's hilarious, too, is I've got stuff marked on the map, you know, put this stuff here and yada yada and all that. I didn't write that. Okay, whatever. It's stuff. It's got nothing in it. Stuff. Nothing. There's nothing there.
So
nothing to see here.
They're just
nothing to see.
Okay.
Let's take a look at this time.
Yeah, sure.
Let's examine the statue.
Okay, perfect.
Does it have the same intricate level of detail?
So why don't you go up to it and examine it?
We are about to.
Yep. Why don't you go up to it and roll some examine action?
All right. Examine plus 4.
There's nothing there.
I'll help.
17.
So I examine plus 9. 27.
Oh,
okay.
You shouldn't be helping me.
Yeah. There you go. So you look at it. It's got the same fine detail to it. Okay, this guy looks like it's the same cutout clothing, same style of clothing and all sort of stuff. Totally different, you know, garb, right? So this guy looks like he's worn like workman's clothing type of stuff together. But the other guy pick was more like a tabard of version. Just a standard pick. It looks just like a regular pick.
What's he using it on?
Using it on the wall. It looks like a wall, exactly. It looks like
it's having the wall is smooth. Though.
And the wall is smooth, that's right.
Yeah. Doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, makes no sense whatsoever. Makes no sense to me yet.
Does he, so far these
is he looking at the wall? Yeah, he's looking at the wall.
Huh, that's what.
Are these statues, are they stoned into the floor? Like, can they be moved?
No, they are not stone in the floor. You believe that, I mean, if you wanted to try, you could probably move them.
We could tip it.
Statue tipping! Let's go statue tipping!
Does this not happen at aquatics?
No, this does not have aquatics.
Does it have any anything around its belt? Anything of note? Tools, keys, no. Trinkets?
No. No. No notes would say this is the entire explanation of the level here. No, nothing like that. No. You gotta look. I mean, you gotta try. Okay, what else do you guys want to do?
Time
find Barbie?
To go down that quarter and find Barbie.
Okay.
So we want the non-slip slide quarter?
The one yes. That's not like the others?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, so you start heading down that corridor. There's really nothing to see here in this corridor except the occasional stalactite, you know, on the ceiling type of thing.
Really? There's stalactites?
Yeah, there's stalactites, yeah.
Do they look like they formed after the corridor was formed?
That's a good question. I'm going to check them out.
Yeah.
I'd like to make a spot check on the thing.
Spot?
Plus 7.
Mm-hmm.
10.
10! Very good. Excellent. Okay, right. So, Cosimo, you know, takes it, so there's some stalactites and all this rhythm. It's like, that's really interesting. I wonder how they were formed. And also, you go up to them, you take a look at them, and everybody roll initiative.
Right. Somehow I knew that was
going
to happen. Plus 4.
Plus 2.
Plus
1.
Plus 3.
Plus 4.
And 19.
14.
Yes!
What the hell am I doing?
Natural 20.
Did you put me at 20?
What are you? You are freaking!
Cause what you and I have to switch, because look at me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For real.
Oh. Oh my god! That'd be pretty impressive. Negative initiative.
Oh wow, do you have a negative mod?
No. I just rolled a 1, and that's all.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow.
I get plus 1, so what to do?
Okay. First of all, everybody's flat-footed.
Yep.
Okay. And you are now in a surprise round.
Surprise half round.
Well, you're surprised, thank you very much. Okay. And so you go up to these, you know, stalactites and all sorts of stuff. It's like, this doesn't fit with the rest of the things here. This is very odd. What's going on with these stalactites? And then, as you're looking at them, these little red eyes open.
Oh.
And the stalactites detach from the ceiling, float down, and then try and cover you.
Ooh.
Cover us. Yeah, no.
They're
you.
Bats.
cover you.
Oh, shit.
Well, your AC is improved.
Exactly. Your AC is as high. Look at that. That's amazing. That was freaking amazing. Oh, that's really impressive. Okay. That was the ace. And then number two.
You missed.
Yeah.
One.
Yes.
Missed. Okay. Yeah. That one's not missing. Thank you very much. Okay. That one hits. Okay.
He's not flat-footed.
He is.
I'm not flat-footed.
You're not flat-footed? That's right.
That's
oh, that would hit.
And your armor class goes down when you're not flat-footed. Thank you very much. So, I don't know whether you should be exclaiming that, proclaiming that so loudly.
Can't he deliberately okay. Not dodge?
All over farm.
Can't he deliberately not dodge? No.
Give up.
Okay, very good. Okay.
Firefly.
Okay, perfect. Let's put some firefly on the board there. Okay, now let's back up for a second. Got something funky. I'm almost certain of it. That's what he's got. Okay, pretty kinky. Okay, so that was the D4. So that's the 3, 7. Okay, so you take 7 points of damage.
Four. Oh!
That looks painful.
God, I'm almost dead.
Well, are you?
I'm more than half gone.
Yep, okay. So what happens is, one of the things, so the first one floats down, flutters down, and all this weird other stuff. You're like, oh my god! You dodge out of the way. And all
wait, it fluttered down? It didn't just let go.
No, it did not drop. These things actually look like they're semi-hovering in the air.
Okay,
right? And then furthermore, now that you're getting a closer look at them, they've all got these beady, you know, eye things on them. You know, which when they're fully closed, look, you can't even see them, but, you know, when they open up, you can see these, you know, red eyes, right? And then when they detach from the ceiling, all of these tentacles fold down, okay? And it almost looks like it's like a squid-like thing that's hovering in the air, except that it really looks like it's a stalactite. It looks like it's like a camouflage, a stalactite, right? And then the tentacles come crawling up out of the top of the stalactite, and it's just trying to wrap its whole body, you know, around you. Okay. Now the first one, you're able to, you know, effectively dodge out of the way, but you realize it's just a cunning tactic to put you directly in the way of the second one. And the second one just envelops you. Now, why don't we make a grapple check? So you use your size AB to your round.
Zero.
That's great.
Woo!
Yeah. Okay. And then what happens?
Did you roll?
Got it.
No.
Okay. And so then the thing, you know, wraps itself around you. The tentacles wrap around. The whole thing sort of, you know, the thing seems to invert and then just crawls around you. And you can feel like little teeth and various other things biting into you. And you think the next round you're fucked. You're fucked bad. Yeah. Okay. So unless, of course, you can, you know, break the rack. So, okay, now, that, okay, so Cosimo's now consumed, so we have to go after somebody else, sadly. I think that clearly it would do so randomly. Okay, very good. Let's just do one break. And the various other things. Number six is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Thjodrann, lucky Thjodrann. Okay. So the witch moves in. It's going to attack you.
Yes.
What's your flat footed AC?
17.
Yeah, well.
Dope. I really shouldn't go first, I'm pleased.
Second.
Right. You were going first, but you were doing, you were looking at
plus 5, so that's a 16.
Yes.
And you, it's a 17. So I can't get any extra bonuses out of that, can I? Okay, fine. So number 3 barely misses Thjodrann, and it's only because Thjodrann saw what was happening before with Cosimo. But you dodge out of the way, like, I'm not going to track that.
That's some bad shit. Yeah,
exactly. That was some pretty bad stuff sometimes. And the other one.
That's not for it for me.
You're not going to be flat-footed?
Bye-bye.
To mark off one of your flat, no flat-footed today. And which moves it. And the other one is like, well, clearly, I like regulars. And attacks Troya. Yeah, fine. Okay. Okay, and that one's not getting much. That's getting not getting very far with Troya. Okay. So the fluttery stalactite things have done their attacks. Okay, now it is the first round of combat. Yeah. Okay, Nina, what do you want to do?
Well,
It's grappling him, it's not trying to dodge me, so it's if it's like grappler on him, it's denied its dex bonus, right?
Anytime that anybody is grappling anybody else, they are denied their dex bonus to AC to outside people, to people who are not in grapple. Okay?
So you could backstab.
Yep.
But and, I would be careful because it's wrapped around.
Also, by the way, remember the way that the new rules work and all this other stuff. These guys are still—they are effectively flat-footed. Just because they got to act in a surprise does not mean that they are not the flat-footed. I really should rename flat-footed, except all the rules say flat-footed. It's really not intended to be flat-footed anymore. Okay. So, so you would be able to get your sneak attack on any of them right now, not just the ones that were
kill, please.
Okay.
Or staff.
Okay, so you mean the one that's not grappling?
No, you know,
right?
My bow.
With the bow?
No, the one that is grappling.
Oh, the one that is grappling.
What's
yeah.
My bow?
Okay, very good. Excellent. Okay,
good. You're going to shoot your arrow at Cosimo.
Yeah.
No, at the stalactite, like the center, not the part that's grappling.
Now, I just want to mention, okay,
the only time ever
that there is a chance that you will hit someone else is when you use a ranged weapon into a grapple. Like, let's say, a bow into a grapple. You have
okay,
a bow.
Okay, I just
mentioned. That's the only time. Okay.
Woohoo!
Page
10 foot.
Put token on.
It's not on the ace, it's on the 2. It's the 2 that's
pretty good. It's grapple. Like the 2.
Yeah. That one, the other one!
Cool! Your Christ will help
a
muffle. Oh, my hand's made a mark and I've got more of a squid on my head.
What's that?
What?
I forgot something.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot something very, very important. This is my bad. So we want to do this before your actual attack, because this is relevant. As they were fluttering down, coming into the whole thing, I'll just read another chapter. The entire area winked out into darkness. Okay, so, and this
is
actually affected. Yes, I know.
My light was already there.
Your light was already there.
And it's gone.
And it's gone now, correct. Okay, so what happens is, the light, it gets, more than that happens, okay, so the light gets gone, and then it's just dark. And then it gets really dark, pitch dark, like you can't see anything. It could potentially could be magical darkness. I forgot about this. It's actually pretty important. Okay, so then, yada, 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 yada. It doesn't actually affect your armor class, so it can't hit you, sadly. Okay, so the witch moves it. So then...
But we can't hit them.
Yes, but you can't even see them. You don't even know where they are. You get it. So what are you going to do? So now it's completely dark.
Light up the area.
Completely dark, yeah, exactly.
Torch, who's got a torch?
What? Try it anyway.
I agree.
It's a completed thing.
You have to light up.
You might not know where to do it.
Okay. Now, by the way, just so you know, so we have a dwarf, a gnome, and a half-orc here. All of you
dark.
That can see in the dark. Okay? Except you can't see in this darkness.
Right.
So you're pretty certain that it's magical darkness at this juncture. Right. If it were just dark,
it's not
like no light, you would be able to do it.
Ryan, it might be.
I would say as well.
The worst that happens is you fail.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I think it's worthwhile.
Nina, if you at least get rid of the magical darkness by canceling with magical light, then at least some of us will be able to see, and I might be able to save Cosimo's life. I don't want to lose any more party rooms on this.
Woo!
He's really intent on this whole losing party members.
I think it's worth it.
Don't ever say
it.
You can't see.
I can't attack it.
You can't see.
Magical light.
Okay. Cosimo. Okay. So where you think Cosimo was? The second one. Okay. So then you cast the magical light there and all this rich other stuff, and then rather than the area lighting up, the pitch dark, suffocating darkness seems to go away. Okay.
So it cancels.
And then the people. How many people do we have here? So we have four people in the party that have the vision thing. So you two, you and Firefly. So you can all now see.
Thank you.
Human dreams cannot yet see.
Don't
you hear people say, thank you, Firefly, and you're sitting there in darkness? Why?
Yeah.
Next time, Nina should be able to light it up.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Do it one more.
Okay. Okay, so Nina, so you're not
going to see.
Excellent.
That was hugely useful.
Yep. Okay.
Cosimo. Okay, so what
I need to do is withdraw.
Withdraw?
I'm grappled.
Whoa, dude. Okay.
He's
grappled, so he can't withdraw. B, if he were, the other one would get an attack of opportunity on him.
Oh, man.
You got a light? No, I don't have light. You got to hire a loot
and...
Oh, wait, no, you're
dead. So what are my options here? One option is
you can die. I'm sorry.
Other than that.
Okay, I just want to make sure there were complete...
Things I can do to avoid
all
dying.
All of the options.
What about spells?
Complete options.
Things I can do to avoid dying. In terms of casting spells, they get attacks of opportunity, which are nasty.
First of all, you cast a spell. You have to make a heinous concentration check because you're in a grapple.
Right.
Being grappled is not optimal for casting spells. Second, you still have this thing with your hands. So you'd have to blow your metamagic feet in order to do the
thing. That's fine. I don't.
Okay. And then three.